Good morning, and thank you for coming. My name is Samat Darakib. I'm the Reproductive Freedom Organizer for the ACLU of Maine. The Maine Alliance for Reproductive Freedom, formerly the Maine Choice Coalition, consists of a range of organizations committed to advocating for and supporting women at all stages of their reproductive lives. The organizations represented here have been working together to preserve reproductive rights in the state of Maine for over 20 years. The Alliance believes that all Mainers should have access to abortion. We also believe that all women should have the economic, social, political power and the resources to make their own decisions about their bodies, their sexuality, their reproductive health, and their families. Over the past year, this dedicated group has been surveying the landscape of reproductive rights here in Maine and across the country. And we feel it's crucial that we name the inequities that exist between women that affect their access to reproductive health care. For example, while access to safe and legal abortion is important, we know that ensuring abortion is legal does not guarantee that poor women and women living in rural areas are able to receive the reproductive health care that they need, including abortion. Beyond the issue of abortion, we know that women who choose to be mothers cherish motherhood. But it's painfully clear that women of color disproportionately fear that they will lose their young sons to police and vigilante violence. Finally, we know that some legislators would like to allow individuals to put their own religious beliefs before women's access to contraception and other family planning services. We are gathered here today to stress upon our legislators the need to pass policy that supports Mainers' rights to have children or not have children, and supports their ability to raise those children in safe and healthy environments. We are here to urge our legislators to make policy that allows Maine women and their families to thrive, because when women thrive, all of Maine thrives. In 2015, the Maine Alliance for Reproductive Freedom has prioritized bills that address a range of reproductive rights issues that are relevant to Maine women and their families. One fundamental component of reproductive justice is the ability to decide whether and when to have children. We believe that a woman should have that ability regardless of income. We also believe that if a woman decides to carry her pregnancies to term, she should not be forced into a situation that would physically compromise the health and safety of her pregnancy. We believe that safe pregnancy is a reproductive justice issue, even if the pregnant person is incarcerated. The Maine Alliance for Reproductive Freedom is proud to support LD 1013, an act to prevent the shackling of pregnant women. LD 1013 will protect women and their pregnancies by banning the use of restraints on a prisoner or detainee known to be pregnant during labor, transport to a medical facility, delivery, and postpartum recovery, except in extraordinary circumstances. Across the nation, women constitute the fastest growing population of incarcerated Americans. Here in Maine, the number of women in our prisons has increased sixfold since 2002, the vast majority sentenced for low-level, nonviolent offenses. Pregnant and parenting women suffer acute harms at the hands of the criminal justice system. A 2010 report by the National Women's Law Center gave Maine a failing grade when it came to the conditions of confinement for pregnant and parenting women, incarcerated women. The grade was based on poor prenatal care, the unavailability of family-based treatment as an alternative to incarceration, and Maine's lack of a shackling policy. Maine is currently the only state in New England that does not ban this cruel and unusual practice. Maine needs LD 1013 to protect the health of a pregnant woman and her fetus. Shackling pregnant women increases their chances of accidentally tripping or falling and harming their pregnancies, and can get in the way of necessary medical care during labor and postpartum recovery. Following birth, it is crucial for a woman to remain unshackled to prevent postpartum hemorrhage. 25 states have already outlawed the shackling of pregnant prisoners. In those states, there have been no documented instances of a woman in labor and delivery escaping or causing harm to themselves, security guards, or medical staff. Policies against the shackling of pregnant women has widespread support both locally and from national, correctional, medical, and human rights bodies. This includes the Federal Bureau of Prisons, the U.S. Marshal Service, U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, the American Correctional Association, the American College of Nurse Midwives, the American Congress of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, the American Medical Association, the American Public Health Association, the Association of Women's Health, Obstetrics and Neonatal Nurses, the National Commission on Correctional Health Care, and the American Bar Association, It is time for Maine to get in line. Here to talk about our support for LD 319, an act to strengthen the economic stability of qualified Maine citizens by expanding coverage of reproductive health care and family services, is Abby Strutt.
The Alliance is proud to support LD 319, an act to strengthen the economic stability of qualified Maine citizens by expanding coverage of reproductive health care and family services. LD 319 will provide low-income, underinsured, and uninsured women access to essential reproductive health care and disease prevention measures. Reproductive health care and access to affordable health care is an essential component of women's economic security. In order to take full advantage of the educational and career opportunities afforded to her, a woman must have control of her reproductive life. LD 319 empowers women to space their children and make personal decisions about when and if to start a family. The bill will prevent unintended pregnancy, support healthy birth spacing, reduce health disparities, and lower maternal morbidity. Conservative estimates find that LD 319 will reduce the number of unintended pregnancies in Maine by 320 the first year and 1,060 in the next 3 years. Low-income women are more than 5 times as likely to experience an unintended pregnancy, which has significant implications for social mobility given that unplanned childbearing is associated with higher rates of poverty, less family stability, and worse outcomes for children. LD 319 provides us with the tools to address this critical issue. Access to contraception, including the most effective methods, could significantly reduce incidences of unintended pregnancy, help women achieve economic security, and save taxpayer dollars. LD 319 is a common sense approach to both spending and women's health and economic opportunity. Not only will this policy create stronger families, it will do so with proven cost savings for taxpayers and the government. We ask our legislators to support LD 319 because it will allow Maine women to participate equally in the economic and social life of this state. And when women thrive, Maine thrives.
Thank you, Abby. If a woman makes the decision to carry her pregnancy to term, it is important that she have access to the resources she needs to raise a healthy child. Having the ability to raise healthy children is a reproductive justice issue. Here to speak about our efforts to defeat bills that weaken our safety net programs is Elizabeth Capone Newton.
My name is Elizabeth Capone Newton, and I came here today to tell you about one of the hardest working groups of people in Maine. I was born and raised in this state, and I know that Mainers are a hardworking bunch. But I'm here to tell you about the ones who often sacrifice the most and get the least recognition. I want us all to remember the real people who too often are forgotten or unheard when policy debates are happening in these very halls. These are the kind of people who get up on the coldest morning of the winter with temperatures more than 10 below zero to stand outside for more than an hour just to put food on the table. They're the woman who gets up at 5 a.m. on her birthday because she wants her son to have health insurance. They're the women that walk long distances all winter with their babies bundled up in a stroller. They're the teenager who translates for her mom so that the mom can continue providing for their family. There are the dozens of people who take costly time away from their daily responsibilities at work, school, and home, just to make sure that they and the people of all ages who depend on them can continue surviving. They are some of the hardest working people in Maine. They are people who receive public benefits. Many of these people are mothers who, like myself, know what it is to work hard caring for our children or for an elderly or disabled relative and receive no compensation for that work. Many of us do double or even triple shifts, We work in low-paying jobs and or go to school, plus doing the unpaid job of caring for our families. Our loved ones depend on us. We, in turn, depend on safety net programs to keep our families fed, clothed, or housed when our paycheck is not enough. As a mother, I will not accept the promotion and glorification of neglect. And that is what the attack on TANF, food stamps, GA, and other public benefits really is. We will not let our state government neglect us. If we care about children, we must care about the adults in their lives too. Bills that propose making it harder for people to eat, for people to have a place to live, for people to have health care, they are really an attack on our entire community, our children, our youth, our parents, our elders, everyone. As mothers, as neighbors who care for each other, we know that our family's well-being is wrapped up in your family's well-being, and vice versa. We will not accept bills that promote the neglect of ourselves and our neighbors. Only a legislature that has lost track of its love for the people of Maine would pull the floor out from under the ones who care for the most vulnerable among us. I know this State House is full of caring people from all parties who will not tolerate that. That's why I am speaking up on behalf of people who receive public benefits to ask that our legislators reject attempts to rip apart our safety net. Instead, we need lawmakers to strengthen that safety net so that all of our neighbors have what they need, not just to survive, but to move ahead in their lives. Here in Maine, caring for each other is truly the way life should be. Thank you.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Some women are not able to carry their pregnancy to term. Those women may choose to end their pregnancies by seeking abortion. The Alliance believes that all women's situations are different and that if a woman chooses to end her pregnancy, that decision is best left to her and her doctor. We believe that equal access to safe and legal abortion is fundamental to reproductive justice. Here to speak about our goals to defeat bills that compromise women's access to abortion is Lynn Holland.
Good morning, I'm Lynn Holler. I'm the mother of a 15-year-old girl, a sophomore in high school. She takes several honors in AP classes, plays clarinet in the marching band, and is a crew member for the school's theatrical productions, and has a boyfriend. We have what a lot of people might think is a pretty typical family. My husband and I will celebrate our 20th anniversary this year. In addition to our daughter, we also have a 13-year-old son. My husband and I are both architects. He practices full time, whereas I stepped away a few years ago in order to juggle our family's needs, along with volunteering and freelance design. At home, we talk about civil and personal rights and freedoms. Now, with our conventional family life as a background, I hope that if my daughter were to become pregnant, she would come to me to discuss her options, including abortion, as difficult as it might be for her. But I have worked hard to raise a thoughtful, independent, self-aware daughter, and she doesn't always do what I wish or hope for. So I can acknowledge that in that moment, she might be experiencing a storm of feelings, and for whatever the reason may be, she might rather go to another trusted adult instead of me. As hurt as I would be in that situation, I have to be an adult and realize that this is not about my feelings. It is about respecting my daughter's rights and judgment about what works best for her. But there are many families where the discussion of an unintended teen pregnancy would be even more complicated than in mine. A teen might feel that exposing her pregnancy to her family would not just be difficult, but in fact could have unbearable results. The news might result in an abusive family member becoming even more so, Or maybe the teen is the victim of incest and would be having this discussion with the perpetrator of her nightmares. That's why I'm so concerned about the consequences of a bill like LD 83, which could have the consequences of a bill like LD 83 could have for young women in our state. This bill, no matter what its intentions may be, will put some women in unsafe and insurmountable situations. Thankfully, LD 83 is not necessary because in Maine, there's already a successful adult involvement law that works. LD 83 would repeal that 25-year-old law and instead require physicians to get signed consent from a minor's parent before she can obtain an abortion. While most young women do include their parents when making decisions about whether to get an abortion, there are times when some teens can't safely talk to their parents about it. LD 83 would unnecessarily put the safety of young women who can't talk to their parents at risk. As a mother, I'm asking our lawmakers to not force young women to put themselves in danger unnecessarily. Please keep Maine's current adult involvement law in place so that young women can safely get the support they need when making important decisions about their pregnancies, even when they can't talk to their parents. That's what I want for my own daughter. Maine has a good law that works. Let's keep it that way. Thank you.
Thank you, Lynn. It is fitting that we come together to announce the Alliance's new mission statement and these legislative initiatives. Expanding our mission and goals has allowed us to advocate more broadly for all women at all stages of their reproductive lives. We recognize that the issue of reproductive rights expands beyond abortion care. If by supporting abortion we are advocating for respect for women's reproductive choices, then we must respect all of the reproductive choices that women make. That includes a woman's choice to have children and her desire to raise them in safe environments. We also recognize that reproductive justice for women translates into economic justice for women. And we know that when women thrive, Maine thrives. We are excited to work with legislators who support women in all of their reproductive choices. We will continue to work to defeat bills that jeopardize women's reproductive and civil rights. This includes laws that allow people to use their personal religious beliefs to claim the right to blank, to claim the right to break important laws that are meant to protect us all. This includes laws like protecting people from discrimination and laws protecting women's health. In closing, as the Maine Alliance for Reproductive Freedom enthusiastically adopts our new name and our new mission statement, we are also enthusiastic to advocate for women at all stages of their reproductive lives. Thank you for coming.